Good evening. Tonight, we'll be taking a special look at a company that certainly has earned its share of headlines over the past 12 months. That company is Redmond-based Microsoft Corporation. For everyone at Microsoft, this certainly has been a year to remember. We'll be back to take a closer look right after this.
How much do you think this advanced operating environment is worth? Wait just 1 minute before you answer. Watch as Windows integrates Lotus 1-2-3 with Miami Vice. Now we can take this Ferrari and paste it right into Windows Write. Now how much do you think Microsoft Windows is worth? Don't answer. Wait until you see Windows Write and Windows Paint and to listen to what else you get at no extra charge. The MS-DOS executive, an appointment calendar, a card file, a notepad, a clock, a control panel, a terminal, a principal, or a RAM driver. And can you believe it? Reversi! That's right! All these features in Reversi, all for just, how much did you guess? 500? 1,000? Even more? No, it's just $99. That's right. It's $99. It's an incredible value, but it's true. It's Windows from Microsoft. Order today. P.O. Box 286. DOS. Except in Nebraska.
Microsoft's year to remember began a year ago in July. Microsoft had just ended the fiscal year with record sales of $140 million, but chose not to rest on its laurels. Instead, the company released C Compiler 4.0 and Quick Basic, which quickly caught on. On the 6th of August, 1985, that man on the left broke ground in Redmond, Washington, giving rise to the expression Microsoft as a whole. That same month, Network Word was announced, and Microsoft Access began to ship, launching Microsoft into the communications software market. The August shipping report looked like this. September got off to a lively start when the people of Microsoft converged on Meany Hall for the annual company meeting. This was the scene as hundreds of techies and yuppies, movers and shakers, interpreters and compilers piled under this once respectable academic venue. There they heard brave predictions. Predictions that Buck Ferguson would cause a new structure to arise in the wilderness. That Excel would soar. CD-ROM would pack the house. And Windows would open. They were not to be disappointed. In the years since, the people of Microsoft have accomplished all of this and much, much more. Last September, Multiplan sold its millionth unit. We asked Microsoft President John Shirley for his thoughts on this milestone.
Let's confirm that total.
Just 1 week later, the other spreadsheet, Microsoft Excel, shipped on time, and Camber moved 15,000 units in the first few days. Rebecca is at Microsoft with the story.
I'm talking to Mike Slade, who was product manager for Excel last fall. Mike, at the time of Microsoft Excel's release, there were many who thought the product would have tough sledding against something called Jazz. Did it?
Well, at first we were very worried. They had a much larger advertising budget. They outspent us 7-1. They had much nicer marketing materials. They had more momentum going in. But we basically just wiped them out.
If Excel were music, what would it be?
It'd be rock and roll.
Rock and roll, indeed. Here's our September shipping report. Out in Redmond, September looked like this. Here's the quarterly book report from Microsoft Press.
AppleWorks, printed word, variations in C. Only three, Jim. Have to do better next quarter.
October 1985 saw version 5.0 of the Microsoft Mouse announced, even as its predecessor climbed to number one on the soft sell charts. An exciting time for this likable rodent. Here's the October shipping report. And in Redmond, the pace continued. By last November, Microsoft was ready to roll into COMDEX with one of the most anticipated shipping announcements in history, Microsoft Windows. We asked Chairman William H. Gates III to assess the importance of the Windows release.
This is awesome.
You heard it here first. Here's the full November shipping report. Microsoft closed out the month with this tranquil scene on the new campus. Last December was book month at Microsoft, as Microsoft Press turned out four stocking stuffers, completing a busy quarter of book releases.
Big quarter. Microsoft Machinations, Apple Macintosh book, second edition, Midnight Madness, running MS-DOS, second edition, Microsoft Basic on Mac, Command Performance Multiplan, Excel in Business, that's a heavy one, hang on there, Jim. Command Performance DBase 3, and Presentation Graphics on the IBM PC. Wow, better slow them down, they'll kill themselves at this rate.
At Camber, December means tree contest time. Rebecca?
At Camber, Christmas means building Christmas trees from stupid junk and having a contest. This year, production won the annual event with an ersatz conifer made of green insert binders, product brochures, and pieces of tape. Mark Rawlsing, can't you people find something better to do with your time?
Well, we did manage to ship 12,000 pieces of Excel at the end of September and first part of October. We're duplicating about 500,000 diskettes a month now, putting together about 125,000 packages. The month of October, a good portion of our time was spent planning a birthday party for someone who shall remain nameless. December was, in addition to the Christmas tree party, we had the Christmas party itself that took a lot of preparation time. But we did manage to set another record sales quarter, as usual.
This is Rebecca Sutherland at Camber Park.
It was also Christmas in Ireland, where the new manufacturing facility began shipping product to good little boys and girls. In Redmond, 1985 ended this way. ...1986, on the other hand, began more like this. In January, Microsoft moved to strengthen operations in Japan with a surprising announcement that it would create its own wholly owned subsidiary, ending a long relationship with an independent firm. Rebecca is at Microsoft to ask why.
We're talking to Microsoft's Ron Hosogi. Ron, tell us the real story behind Microsoft's decision to develop its own subsidiary in Japan.
その本当の理由っていうのは、日本の市場で我々が活躍するために自分たちで独立した組織を欲しかったところです。で、もう一つは、日本で今まで
January's shipping report featured Project 2.0, and Cran Raspberry emerged as the juice of choice. January and February were seminar months, with a successful Windows development seminar in Seattle and equally successful Network Word seminars in New York, Chicago, and San Francisco. This is a typical seminar attendee, Prince Charles, seen here with several close friends. February also saw the announcement of Microsoft Networks for Xenix. In Redmond, meanwhile, this was the scene as work continued far into the night. If there is one month to be remembered above all others in this year to remember, it is March 1986. In a span of about 2 weeks, Microsoft moved, produced the first international conference on CD-ROM, and went public. This was the scene at the CD-ROM conference, which drew more than 1,000 people. The big move, pictured here, nearly killed another 1,000, while the public offering knocked them dead back on Wall Street. Rebecca has a few questions about all this activity for Microsoft's chief financial officer, Frank Gaudette.
Frank, can you give me one good reason why Microsoft chose to move and go public at the same time?
Yes. They both start with a hole. One with a hole in the ground and the other with a hole in your head.
Well, under the circumstances, why were both so successful?
Well, because we filled in the holes. One, we built a very nice campus location, and the other one, we built a good team and had a good underwriting.
At this point, can you reveal your plans to ensure that next March will be even more challenging than last March?
Yes, we're planning an international St. Patrick's Day party here on campus.
This is Rebecca Sutherland at Microsoft Campus in Redmond.
Here's the quarterly book report.
Let's see. This quarter we have Microsoft File and Lotus 1-2-3, CD-ROM, Papyrus, and AppleWorks.
After a month like March, some might have expected things to ease off in April. Not so at Microsoft, because Flight Simulator for the Macintosh took off to start the month. In sports, word 3-0 took to the field, and the coaches were optimistic. Tony has the latest word.
Tina Poe, one of the great coaches from Microsoft, gotten in a trade several years ago. I don't think we have to talk about that because there's still some repercussions from that thing. But is there anything else from Microsoft Word that we ought to know here?
Well, no, just one thing. Microsoft Word's been real hot. If you take a look at worldwide, what the number one word processor is, it's Microsoft Word. And we're confident that in the U.S., we'll just keep going real, real strong throughout this whole season.
Well, you know, Tina, Microsoft is proud to have you and also proud to have this little guy here. What a cutie. Microsoft Word is going to be hot.
Thanks
for 86. Tina, thank you very much for being with us.
We understand that the front office is also high on this player.
Totally awesome.
April was a month for winners. Microsoft Windows won three major awards. Microsoft Excel won two, and Microsoft Project earned one, for a total of six. Also in April, Big Blue announced DOS 3.2 as the operating system for its new PC convertible. In May, Microsoft won the 1986 Washington Governor's Export Award. Rebecca?
Here with me is Scott Oakey, formerly Microsoft's Vice President for International Sales. Scott, why did Microsoft receive the Governor's Export Award?
Oh, I think the reason was the phenomenal growth that the company has experienced over the past 4 years. 4 years ago, we were doing about $2 million internationally, and the most recent fiscal year, we've done about $81 million. That's pretty significant growth.
Well, Microsoft's international sales have obviously soared. How would you explain the success?
It's hard to explain all the reasons, but if I had to summarize, I'd say that it's three primary reasons, the first being great products. We have MS-DOS and Windows and all of the language compilers, certainly the applications like Multiplan, Word, the Macintosh family. All of these are really phenomenal, and we've even gone to the pains to localize these products into various mother tongues. In fact, last fiscal year, we localized over 60 different products. This coming fiscal year, we'll localize over 120 different products. The second reason, I'd say, is really great people. We need an awful lot of support here at headquarters, and we get it. In addition to that, we complement it with about 200 people that work for us in the international countries. And the final reason, we have a maniacal work ethic.
This is Rebecca Sutherland on the Microsoft campus. Back to you, Jeff.
May also saw Canberra set a record with an all-time high 20,549 shipments. The entire company was grateful. And so, too, we understand, was Interlake Porsche Audi. June wrapped up another busy quarter for Microsoft Press.
Got Xenix at work. Mac Insights. Our Juvenile series, my first book about computers. My first book about BASIC. It's Microsoft BASIC. My first computer dictionary. And our complete desk reference calendar. But you know, Jim, next year, we can lighten things up. Because all those books will fit on about 2% of this disk. Just think how much lighter and easier it'd be if we did 27 of these instead of 27 books.
I can't wait.
July was magazine month at Microsoft, with articles about the company in Money and Fortune. Microsoft also announced record sales in July of 1986, totaling $197 million.
This is truly awesome.
The retail division was also jubilant. July was also a big month for the Microsoft Hardware Group, which announced two new products, Mach 10 and the Import Device Interface. Inasmuch as July was the first anniversary of Quick Basic 1.0, Microsoft celebrated by releasing version 2.0. In August, Microsoft Works was introduced for the Macintosh, a move sure to extend the firm's dominance over the Macintosh software universe. Today, as September begins, the people of Microsoft have once again converged on Meany Hall, filled with hubris and free lunch, to celebrate their remarkable achievements and to dedicate themselves to an even brighter tomorrow. Rebecca is at Meany Hall with this inspiring story.
Just 11 years ago, Microsoft had but two employees, one product, one client, and no offices. Today, in poignant contrast, the firm possesses its own lake with two waterfalls. Inside this hall at this very moment are 1,000 dedicated people who are about to give themselves a big round of applause for a job well done. Let's go inside.
Feel when you found out the Macro Assembler won PC Magazine's Programming Product of the Year in 1985.
Great. A lot of people worked around the clock to make that a world-class product.
The year was 1985.
Hello.
Yeah, basic compiler. Sure, yeah, we got a fast one. Compiles at 9,000 lines a minute in memory. Yeah, it's really quick. It's quick basic. Yeah, that's it. That's the ticket.
Sounds good.
Editor? Yeah, smart idea. Yeah, it's a smart editor. Yeah, the editor finds your compilation errors and points at them. Yeah, so you can fix them one at a time.
But of course, we'll need compatibility with your basic interpreter.
Sure, 150 times faster than that. No problem. Yeah, cost? Right, I can get it to you for $9.99. Yeah, that's it.
Well, we've got a lot of really large programs.
No problem. We have a C compiler that has a huge model. Yeah, huge model. That's the ticket. It's got all the latest ANSI features, and it does register allocation, yeah, and far pointers, too. That's it. We're talking really slick, tight code, yeah.
Okay, but we're gonna need a really good debugger.
No problem. I'll give you a source-level debugger. Yeah, it lets you view the code. Yeah, code view, yeah, yeah. And I'll give it to you for free. Free, yeah, that's it. We're talking expressions, registers, variables, global and local. Yeah, yeah. All while you execute. That's it. By the way, could you really use a killer macro assembler? It's 3 times faster. Great. Huh?
Are your people willing to sign up for this?
No problem. I can get it to you in 6 months. Yeah, that's it. 6 months. No problem. 6 months. Hello?
Palmer freaking.
What?
Bates is weeping. Can't get Shirley on the phone.
Hit it, boys. Gotta do basic. Real quick.
It's astounding. Time is fleeting. Madness takes control.
Listen closely. Not for much longer.
I've got to keep control.
I remember doing the code spec, writing that zig zag code, coding the night away, and Bill's voice is calling.
Let's change the product again. Let's change the product again.
Just a shift to the left.
And a rotate right.
Put your hands on the keys.
And have the code in tight.
Then tune it till it screams.
Gonna drive me insane. Let's fix the product again. Let's fix the product again.
Alpha release and the bug scroll free. At the beta release, no more to see.
In the big blue dimension, with perfect intention,
let's ship it!
With the flip of a bit, your schedule might slip, and nothing can ever be the same.
Let's start a sensation.
Market penetration.
Let's build a product again. Let's build a product again.
When I was writing a compiler just to pass the time of day, my manager's begun, and here is what he say. You can gnash your teeth, you can scream and weep. Got to ship this sucker early next week. He stared at me till I signed up for the pain. He plied me with some hope, so I do it again.
Let's ship the product again. Let's ship the product again.
Shift to the left.
And a rotate right.
Put your hands on the key.
Back the code in tight.
Then tone it till it screams.
Gonna drive me insane. Let's ship the product again. Let's ship the product again.
Hello.
You really surprised me. You delivered everything you promised.
Fact.